Hello, welcome viewers, welcome learners to this short presentation where I want to take you through the ECZ 2007 paper 1, question 4A. This was question 4A. From time to time I bring to you very simple questions but tricky so that I help you build your competences in those areas. So here we have another question that I want us to look at. Very common in paper 1, but it came in 2007. So let's get started. Given that the number of elements in set A is 18 and the number of elements in set B is 14, then the intersection, the number of elements in the intersection, the number of elements in the intersection of A and B, the number of elements in the intersection of A and B is what? 6. Okay? The number of elements in the intersection. This is our intersection. So always, we are supposed to start from the intersection. Are we together? Then now, we come this side. The number of elements in A, how many are there? 18. The entire A should give us how many? 18 elements. So from the 18, we already have 6. So we're going to subtract these 6 from 18. So what are we going to remain with? We're going to remain with 12. We do the same thing. 12 should have B has 14 elements. Now from the 14th, if you look at the entire set, we have what? 6 already. So we need to knock out the 6 from the 14. What are we going to get? We're going to get 8. Okay? The question is not yet done. And then we're told that the number of elements that are outside, because we have got A union B enclosed in the brackets, then outside we've got a complement. So this means outside of A and B, outside of A or B, okay, outside of A or B. So we are saying you have got this, okay? The area that we are talking about here is this one. Outside here, there are two. Okay, they are two. So if we are to answer our question using a Venn diagram, this is what we are going to get. This is what we are going to get. Now the question is asking us to say how many elements are in the union of A or B, the union here. Okay, the union of A and B. Like we have to look at all the elements that I found in E, A and B. So it is these elements here. These elements. Which is what? We add these ones. Plus, plus, plus. What do we get? We are going to get 26. Answered correctly. I hope you did the same thing, because the best that you're supposed to do when you're looking at these things, when I give you a question, pause the video, do it on your own, then after that, you compare. Okay? That is very important. So, this was the question that I brought to you today. Okay? Until next time, don't forget to subscribe and remember that this channel already has a lot of lessons from grade 10 up to 12, as well as a number of past papers that have been extensively solved, okay, with a detailed explanation. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time.